Bill 47 was going for a final vote at Queen's Park Tuesday afternoon. Then 15 in fairness folks packed the gallery, raised a ruckus, and the vote was postponed. Next day, the lily-livered Ford cons passed the bill, grinning like brain-diseased cannibals, as they screwed the working people of Ontario. With Bill 47, the Ford cons are aping Donald Trump in rolling back any progressive legislation passed by their predecessors. Of course, for the win libs, these minor progressive changes were just a Hail Mary pass on their way out the door. But the hash king of Etobicoke and his big business cronies can't stand no kind of progress. Funny that the one thing Ford couldn't do was get people their legal pot on time. I guess running a business is easier when you just avoid the law. Now Ford wants every big business in Ontario to run like a cartel. Roll back enforcement. Banco your local con politico. Pay workers whatever you want. Bill 47 takes workers back to the bad old days. No $15 wage increase until 2025. No paid sick days. Teeny weeny little fines when bosses maim workers or steal wages. And a return to stupid doctor's notes wasting precious doctor time. Did I say this will mostly hurt women? A union might help you, if you could get one. But we're back to employers threatening to shut down before you can vote to join a union. You know, just like Walmart likes it. The Ontario government's doublespeak would make even an Orwell terrorcrat blush. The Ontario Open for Business Act is just a dog whistle for corporate exploiters to know that Ontario is open for class war on workers. The Ford government is a puppet regime for big business. Small business and actual people are just human shields. The Ford cons aren't for the people. They're just for rich white people with penises. In Toronto, for Rabble TV, I'm Umberto Da Silva.